It's all about what he wants. It's about making his point. It's about having his way. It's about doing what he wants to do. A wrathful man is an ungodly man, because he's walking according to the lust of his flesh. Then there's strife, which is selfish ambition. And it gives rise to rivalry. This is the problem of self-interest. And when one would rather look out for themselves,
all right,
rather than the better welfare of other people, mm-hmm, with strife, people exercise a great degree of selfishness, mm-hmm, to the degree that they will do what Paul talks about next, which is cause divisions,
all right,
or seditions, mm-hmm, it is in the text, mm-hmm, but seditions is divisions, mm-hmm, or dissensions that come from that spirit of strife. Mm-hmm. This is when an individual will separate themselves from other folk who don't go along with what they want to do.
All right.
Hello in here. Mm-hmm. And see, as a child of God, you always need somebody who ain't afraid to tell you you're wrong.
All right.
Right, man.
Amen. Amen. And a child of God, you don't ever want to just go along, mm-mm, with what folk are doing. In Galatians chapter 1, the Apostle Paul had talked about the fact that when he had first come to Jerusalem, he realized that there was some sedition type activity going on with those other apostles. Paul said in Galatians chapter 1, verse 18, then after 3 years, I went up to Jerusalem to see Peter, mm-hmm, and abode with him 15 days. But the other apostles saw I none, save James, the Lord's brother. He says, now the things which I write unto you, behold, before God, not lying, not. Paul said, I ain't lying to you. Now this is exactly what took place. Mm-hmm. He said, after I came to the regions of Syria and Cilicia, and was unknown by face to the churches of Judea which were in Christ, they had heard only that he which had persecuted us in time past now preacheth the faith which he once destroyed, and they glorified God. Paul said, then 14 years after, I went up to Jerusalem with Barnabas, and I took Titus with me, went up by revelation, and communicated unto them that gospel which I preached among the Gentiles, but privately to them which were of reputation, lest by any means I should run or have run in vain. He said, but neither Titus, who was with me, being a Greek, was compelled to be circumcised, and that because of false brethren, unawares, who came in privately to spy out our liberty, which we have in Christ Jesus. Why they do it, Paul? He said that they may bring us into bondage. Paul said, but we gave them no such place, not even for an hour, so that the truth of the gospel may continue on with you. He said, drop down to verse 9. Even when James, Cephas, and John, who seemed to be pillars, perceived the grace that was given unto me, they gave to me and Barnabas the right hands of fellowship, mm-hmm, that we should go unto the heathens, and they to the circumcision. Mm-hmm. Only they would that we should remember the poor, the same which I was also forward to do. Mm-hmm. He said, but when Peter was come, uh-huh, to Antioch,
yes, sir,
I withstood him to the face, because he was to blame. Before that certain came from James, He did eat with the Gentiles. But when they were come, he withdrew and separated himself, fearing them which were of the circumcision. And the other Jews dissembled likewise with him, insomuch that even Barnabas was carried away with their dissimulation. But when I saw that they walked not uprightly according to the truth of the gospel, I said unto Peter before all of them, that if you are a Jew, live after the manner of the Gentiles, and not as do the Jews. Why do you compel the Gentiles then to live as do the Jews? What Paul was saying, that there was some pillars in the faith.
Yes.
Even James, John, and Peter, who had been taken by this seditious spirit, this ability to cause division in the body of Christ, back in the context of this structure, they had individuals who were coming in and telling the Gentiles that even though they had been baptized, they still had to be circumcised in order for them to be right with God. See, the Jews held on to the fact that they were the chosen people of God, and they always looked forward to the time when God would come back and set them back up as a nation among nations. They always looked forward to the time when God would come back and reestablish them as a kingdom, as they were during the times of David and Solomon. They looked forward to God having favor upon them and them being the favored of God. But see, the gospel message was so special that it included the Jew and the Gentile alike. When God got ready to do a new thing, he set that old order to rest. He nailed that old law to the cross. He nailed that old way where the Jews were his chosen people. He buried that type of activity, and now he opened up the access so that Jew and Gentile could now become his child. And because of that, there were some Jewish brethren who still didn't want to deal with the Gentile brethren. That was nothing short of a seditious, divisive way to keep God's folks separated, because even the devil recognizes that if God's folk band together, and if they study together, if they pray and worship together, if they work together, if they start helping each other, and if nobody looks on their own things, but everybody looks out for what's best for everybody else, then that's when the Lord's church is going to thrive and grow. That's when the people in the world will see that we are who we say we are, and that is the children of the Most High God. When the people of God get together, we can sure enough do more together than we ever can apart. And that's why Paul wanted all of us to understand the essence of what it meant to be seditious, to call yourself divisive, to put folk against other folk is a devilish habit. To talk about somebody, to get somebody against that somebody that you talked about, is a devilish activity. It ain't nothing but the root and the offspring of Satan that will cause an individual to pull somebody to the side and tell them some dirt on somebody that they don't even know, just to cause this person to have a problem with the person that they got a problem with. That's the way the devil operates, because he realizes that if he can keep God's folk divided, if he could keep us fighting each other, then we'll no longer fight denominations.